Hello friends, we are continuing our discussion of part 6, 12th standard, question number 5-6. The spin only magnetic moment for CrCu6, look at Cr, it is 3d5 4s1, alright, and if you look at the configuration 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, alright, this is the configuration. This is S4S1 and this is 4P3. The type of hybridization is D2SP3. So obviously these three electrons, they must be vacated. So they get paired up like this. So we don't have any unpaired electrons. Alright. All the electrons get paired up. So the magnetic moment is zero. Question number 5-6, correct answer is first option. Look at 5-7. The coloration of KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7 or any other compound having very dark color, it is due to charge transfer from ligand to metal. It is charge transfer from ligand to metal, CTLM. So this you must remember. It is due to charge transfer from ligand to metal. Correct answer is third option. Color of KMnO4, K2Cr2O7, etc. Alright. Next, carbon monoxide, the bond length is given. It is 1.128. In carbon monoxide, the bond length is given. It is 1.128. And if you compare the bond length in pentacarbonyl iron 0, actually in metal carbonyl we have one synergic bond, that is between metal to ligand, like this is carbon monoxide, and you will find this kind of bond, all right, between filled d orbital of metal and vacant antibonding molecular orbital of carbon monoxide. So this is called synergic bond or back bond, due to which the bond length of carbon monoxide is also further strengthened, and the bond length is less than 1.128. So it is 1.15, alright, first option. There are two lower values, actually it should not be there. 1.15 is the correct answer. Question number 5-9. Look at question number 5-9. This is treated with, this compound is treated with C2H5O negative. Temperature condition is not mentioned. If temperature condition is not mentioned, it is simply a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Cl is getting removed as Cl negative and C2H5O negative attacks this carbon atom. This is simply SN2 mechanism. Alright, it is a strong nucleophile we are taking, and media is not polar. If it is polar media, then there is a possibility of SN1 mechanism, rearrangement, etc. So here we don't have any possibility of rearrangement. It is simply nucleophilic substitution reaction. Alright, question number 6-0. An ethereal solution of alkyl halide is heated with the sodium metal. The reaction is known as, this is Wood's reaction, that is Rx plus twice of Na plus Xr. Alright, this is nucleophilic, this is Wood's reaction, Rr. Question number 61, ethyl bromide is industrially prepared from. Question number 61. Ethyl bromide is industrially prepared from ethyl alcohol plus HBr, if you want to prepare ethyl bromide. So this is almost, both are same, but since it is ethyl alcohol is mentioned, so it is C2H5OH plus HBr. Alright, so this is the removal of H2O and Br attacks on this. This is the removal of H2O and we get C2H5Br like this. Ethanol does not react with bromine, so we are left with only first option. Question number 62, when ethyl alcohol reacts with the carbonyl chloride, ethyl alcohol treated with the thionyl chloride SOCl2. It's C2H5OH plus SOCl2 thionyl chloride. This is the removal of SO2, removal of HCl, and we get C2H5Cl. So the correct answer is second option. All right. Question number 67. Question number 63. Look at question number 63. Okay. Look at question number 63. In question number 63, the question is general formula of homologous series of alkanols. It is C2H2N plus O. As such, there is nothing to explain. Question number 64. Conversion of C6H5ONa. When so this reaction is given, question number 64, the correct answer is 2, second option. All right, in this question, you should be careful. The correct answer is second option. So it can be compared like this. Like if you look at the if you look at the this is phenate part, all right, and this is phenol. This is the acid and this is the conjugate base. And second, you have to compare is H2CO3, and its conjugate base is you can say HCO3 negative. Now, if you compare these two, this is the acidic strength, so obviously the basic strength is opposite. Since phenol is a weaker acid than H2CO3 carbonic acid, its conjugate part, that is phenate ion, is a stronger base than HCO3 negative. So correct answer is 64, correct answer is second option. Carbonic acid is a stronger acid than phenol. Now look at question number 65, Clemmensen reducer. Clemmensen reducer is zinc amalgam and HCl. Clemmensen reducer is zinc amalgam and HCl. All right. It reduces carbonyl group. It reduces carbonyl group into methylene group. Now, one more such reduction is called Wolff-Kishner reduction, and the reducing agent is hydrazine and KOH. All right. Now look at question number 60. After 65, correct answer is fourth option. Question number 66, oxidation of toluene to benzaldehyde. This is again very important conversion. This is called Itard reaction, that is conversion of toluene using CrO2Cl2 in CCl4 or carbon disulfide, followed by hydrolysis. What we get is benzaldehyde. This is called Itard reaction. All right. Look at question number 66, correct answer is third option. Look at 67. All right, look at question number 67. The compound colored due to charge transfer. See, I told you charge transfer, that is charge transfer from ligand to metal. KMnO4, K2CR2O7, CU2O, etc. Correct answer is all of these. Coloration, deep coloration of any compound of transition metal is due to charge transfer mechanism or charge transfer from ligand to metal. Question number 68, correct answer is third option. This is incorrect statement. Tollens reagent is used to detect unsaturation. No, Tollens reagent is used to detect reducing character, like aldehydes, they reduce Tollens reagent or Fehling solution, etc. Fehling solution is also used to detect glucose, alright, because of aldehyde group. FeCl3 is used in the detection of phenol. We get violet coloration, alright, of hexaphenoxoferrate 3. So question number 68, correct answer is third option. Look at question number 69. Which of the following, amongst the following will answer positive carbylamine test? Carbylamine test is a reaction of primary aliphatic amine or primary aromatic amine with CHCl3 and KOH, and the product obtained is RNC. It has a very bad smell. So the correct answer is any primary amine. So we have primary aliphatic amine, this aromatic amine, second option. This is secondary amine, this is secondary amine, and this is tertiary amine. Next question, question number 70. Which of the following reagents cannot be used for the given conversion? Like we want to convert a nitrobenzene to aniline. LiLH4 cannot be used. If LiLH4 is used, we get basically azobenzene. It is reduced to azobenzene. This LiLH4 cannot be used for this conversion. Tin HCl we can use, or FeHCl, etc. we can use. Okay.